Hello, welcome to netvn channel. You are confused when managing information technology devices. You can't remember who you gave those devices to, since when, still under warranty or not. If you have that problem, then you need a management software to solve it. In this video I will introduce you to the software that is not IT. Snippet is open source software that runs on Linux operating system, so I will guide you to install it on virtualized environment. The hypervisor I use is VirtualBox. You can use VMware or Hyper-V also. The Linux operating system used in this video is Ubuntu. After installing VirtualBox hypervisor and downloading the Ubuntu 20.04 ISO file, I created a new virtual machine. You set up the virtual machine's network and bridge mode so that other computers on the same local network can access your Snippet software. The most important thing when installing an Ubuntu virtual machine is to assign it a static IP address. Because you will use this static IP address to access the Snippet software from the real computer or other computers on the local network. During the installation of the Ubuntu virtual machine, you are asked to create a new account. Please write it down to use in the next step. The installation of OpenSSH server is necessary because you will use it to install Snippet in the next step. The setup steps are done. Wait a few more minutes for the installation to complete. After the installation is complete and the virtual machine restarts until the login screen appears, move on to the next step. Because you have OpenSSH server enabled for your virtual machine, you can remotely access it using the account you created while installing Ubuntu. You open a command window, enter your username, IP address, and finally enter the password of the account you just created. Here you will be overwhelmed with so many commands to do, but it's okay to do them one by one, from top to bottom. And even simpler, just copy and paste the commands like I will do in the next part of this video. You will find these commands in the description of the video. Before I install Snippet, I need to prepare a web server, so I will install the popular web server software Apache. With a software, a database is indispensable and I choose MariaDB. Finally, PHP and a lot of modules included. I don't understand all these included modules and you can just copy and paste. Because of the requirements of the Snippet software, you need to install additional PHP extensions. You restart the Apache software to apply the changes. The Snippet software requires a PHP composer, so you download and install it. Next is the database. You create a new database called Snippet. Username is snipuser and password is password. You write this down so Snippet can connect to your database in the next step. Now that you have the web server, database, and necessary components, you need to install Snippet. You download Snippet and create a new folder called Snippet. Snippet gives you a sample config file so you can copy it into a config file of your own. Next, you use the information prepared in the previous step to configure your own Snippet software. You configure the URL with your static IP address. Here my static IP address is 10.11.32.82. Next, you set the time zone that is suitable for where you live. You go back to the previous step to find the information about the newly created database and add it to your installation file. In this example, the database name is Snippet, the username is snipuser, and the password is password. After fully updating the information, use the key combination CTRLX, then select Yes to save the changes. Next, configure ownership and permissions with your Snippet folder. After you install the dependencies using Composer, you will get some warnings, but that's normal. You choose Yes when asked. In addition, you will also be asked to enter a password for your Ubuntu account. If you have one, please provide it. Next, you will generate a key for the Snippet configuration file and enter yes when asked to choose. That's it, you have configured Snippet. Next, you create a configuration file for your new website. This new website will help you access the Snippet software and use it. Here you enter your static IP address, then copy the config file as above. Don't forget to save the config file you just created. You disable the default Apache config file and enable the config file you just created for Snippet. It's time to enjoy the results after 15 minutes of installation. You use any web browser and access the Snippet software with your IP address. A screen of the Snippet software has appeared like it was successful. Here you will be asked to create an admin account for your software. Please write it down to use Snippet in the future operation. And here is the result we've been waiting for. Next step, I will add an IT device and assign a user. With the first time adding a new device to manage the information, you will need to add quite a lot, such as company name, manufacturer, catalog, distributor, model, username. But once you have entered certain devices, your work becomes easier and easier. In addition, the software also supports you to import information from the file. You will find it really useful once you use it for a while. In addition, you can generate QR codes and barcodes for your device. To print these device codes, you use Brother printers. In this video, I add a new laptop made by Dell and given to John to use. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to netvn channel.